Hey, good afternoon. How are all of my beautiful soul family members doing today? Hope you're all having a beautiful Sunday today. Today is Sunday, August the 25th, and the time is 3:36 p.m. And I'm doing a tarot reading today, another one. It just really felt like I wanted to do this. I wanted to be able to reach out and to be able to share. And I have the time and the energy right now today to do this. All right? So this means a lot to me to be able to do it. And I'm in a very good mood too. Thinking a lot about spiritual growth and what I'm seeing. And I've been seeing it for a while now from all of you. And I see it throughout the comments. Comments towards me, comments towards one another. I see so many of you, each and every one of you, growing spiritually, which is just, it's a beautiful thing. To simplify it, you're hopefully experiencing life with more unconditional love, right, within you, coming from a place of unconditional love, understanding, forgiveness, fewer opinions, fewer judgments, right? I mean, we're all imperfect, so it's not about being perfect. It's progress, not perfection. I recognize it in the comments, and I'm becoming very, very aware of it, and it makes me very happy. And I just want to let you guys know that you guys lift and inspire me. You do. You make me want to rise and to be better, right? You inspire me to be more loving, right? More understanding, more patient. To recognize, right, the beauty in life. You guys do. You lift and inspire me. So this is my opportunity to be able to give back. So thank you for giving me the opportunity. So the background music that I'm playing today is the Love Frequency, right? Just some good soothing vibes. Perfect Sunday vibes. So prior to starting the reading, I just want to tap the crystal healing bowl and just let it sing kind of a little Sunday song to us for a moment here. And perfect time to just clear our energy, remove ourselves from the outcome of the reading, and take ourselves to a space and a place where we're open to receiving, to hearing any messages that may be meant for you to hear today. And I feel like there are, just like yesterday, I feel like there are going to be some meaningful messages today. Okay. Extended that a little bit today, being Sunday and all. But that sounded really nice on this end. Hope it came through beautifully on your end as well. Okay, so we're going to start today's tarot reading by pulling an affirmation card. We just want to see which affirmation our guides feel would be best suited for us to hear taking us into today's tarot love reading. I'm going to shuffle that again. Okay, so opening affirmation, taking us into today's tarot love reading. Beautiful affirmation. It seems familiar, right? I think we had this affirmation just recently. It's beautiful. Joy, the number 16, which reduces to a 7. 7 representing spiritual wisdom and strength. As I do will, so mote it be, let joy and light radiate from me. As I do will, so mote it be, let joy and light radiate from me. As I do will, so mote it be, let joy and light radiate from me. Okay, love this affirmation, and yes, it does feel very familiar to me. We had this affirmation come up, I think not yesterday, but the day before. But I don't think we read from the guidebook that day about this affirmation, so I want to take a moment today. It's Sunday, why not? And read real quickly from the guidebook, because this guidebook is just filled with these little nuggets of truth and wisdom. Okay, soul family members. Joy is the magical energy that runs, whirls, and dances through the universe. It is both the anticipation and recognition of the opportunities for happiness. Within every moment, joy is a bubbling over of divine happiness, a dip into the cosmic well of hope and freedom. We are all joyful, we are divine, and magic. Work to experience joy is more often and more fully sacred, powerful, and a wonder of the universe. If this card shows you, welcome to a bubbling spring of joy in your life. Working this spell will help you experience intense delight and an almost delirious feeling of innocent appreciation of all that is around you. You will be able to see and feel the beauty in each moment, and the universe will love you all the more for casting such a beautiful, positive spell. If you chose this card, joy will come to you after you cast the spell, even during its casting. Joy's delightful power will leave you refreshed and happy, with peaks of effervescent euphoria. Enjoy it, and remember that it is time, that this time is important to reconnect you with the essential essence of your magical, instinctual nature. Okay, I'm really glad we read this. I think we read it the other day too, but it's such a beautiful and meaningful affirmation. And what I was thinking and connecting to as I was reading that to you guys is kind of what I was talking about in the beginning of the recording today, about spiritual growth, right? About recognizing it, seeing it, and feeling it within all of you. And what's happening is you're embracing more unconditional love. You're resonating, you're creating more of that energy of unconditional love within you, right? And because of that, you attract more unconditional love, right? Which inevitably, what it brings into our lives is joy, right? Lasting happiness. Okay, kind of have goosebumps. All right. Let's start today's tarot love reading. Okay, so opening energy, taking us into today's tarot love reading, we have the Knight of Wands. So the Knight of Wands represents fire sign type energy. So it could be Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Doesn't have to be, right? But this is a fast-moving energy. You can tell by the image on this card, right? Knights always show up. And how does this knight show up, right? He's on his horse, on its hind legs, right? So he comes in quickly, right? So he's moving, a lot of speed. So this is a good energy, right? If we can learn to harness that positive energy, but it can also have its limitations as well. And the limitations with this energy is many times it's moving so quickly and manifesting that when it manifests something, it realizes that's not what it wanted to manifest. Right? So it's just important that we point that out. I'm smiling because we're seeing this energy showing up, seems to be showing up somewhat frequently, which is the Fool's card, the Fool energy. This is the first card in the world of tarot, the first of the major arcanas. It's representing the Fool, so the beginning of a journey, so a newness. What it represents is kind of embracing that energy of letting go of fears and worries and concerns, right? Just like the figure here is demonstrating on the card. She's standing on the edge of this cliff. You would think she would be worried and concerned, but she's not. She's looking at the butterflies and paying attention to the beauty of life, right? So it's representing that energy of moving into something a little fearlessly, but not bringing any weight or baggage from previous experiences, right? Stepping into it with newness and faith and trust. Okay. Okay. So coming in next to the Fool card, we have the Five of Swords. So the Five of Swords represents a limiting energy of, if you look at the figure here in the card, she has these two swords that are in her back. So, you know, it could be depicted as that energy of feeling like somebody stabbed you in the back, right? Being let down, feeling like somebody was there for you only to learn that they weren't, right? So when it happens, we feel it, we experience it, sometimes deeply. Sadness, grief, hurt, and pain. But afterwards, right, then comes the growth. So many times we're able to look inward, right, because maybe there's a part of us that had some level of responsibility, right? Rarely are things ever just completely one-sided, right? And so we're able to see that insight, right, receive that, and absorb that growth, right? So if we focus on the growth, it's what helps us to be able to get past the pain and the hurt. Okay, showing up next, and showing up at the center of today's Tarot Love reading, we have the Justice card, which is the card of Libra. So some of you, you may be a Libra, you may have a Libra in your life. Showing up here at the center of the Tarot reading puts some significance and importance on this energy. This is about balance, right? She stands above the river of truth. In one hand, she holds a sword. In the other hand, she holds the scales of justice, right? So this represents justice, fairness, and balance, right, coming into your atmosphere. I'll know more as more cards come out. Okay, coming in next to the Justice card, we have the Eight of Cups. So the Eight of Cups is a good energy. It represents the energy. If you look at the figure here in the card, notice that she's walking out of the water, right? Water represents a lot of emotions and feelings. So she's walking away from something. Emotions and feelings that may be difficult for her to walk away from. She's even reaching up to grab the branch, right? To kind of stabilize herself. So this is the universe encouraging, you know, this energy of something in your life that's important that you walk away from, right? Something, an energy that's just no longer serving you. This can be realized that it's going to be different for each and every one of us, right? For some, it may be an energy outside of ourselves. For others, it may be something within ourselves that we're walking away from. Okay, coming in next to the Eight of Cups, we have the Chariot card. So the card of Cancer. So some of you may be Cancer, have a Cancer in your life. The energy in this card, what it represents is, represents movement, right? Movement that's coming in, change that's coming into your atmosphere. Change that you're creating, that you're bringing into your atmosphere. And it's change that it'll arrive at its destination with balance, right? The Chariot is being pulled by a black horse and a white horse, representing duality, the yin and the yang, the masculine and the feminine. So it's a balance of these two horses, right? Running together, these two energies, that brings this movement, right? This change into your life. Okay, coming in, attached to the Fool card, right, we have, it's been another pretty prominent energy showing up in tarot readings lately, and it's the Page of Wands. The Page of Wands represents a message, right, news, could be a text, a phone call, email, conversation, could be coming in by way of a fire sign, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. So it'd be a younger energy. It's coming in attached to the Fool card. I need to look at that one for a moment. see what all that means. Okay, so coming in next, and coming in attached to the Five of Swords, we have the Hanged Man. Right? So the Hanged Man represents an energy of sacrifice for some, right? If you look at the figure here in the card, he hangs by his ankles, suspended. He wears a blindfold over his eyes, right? So this is representing a decision, a choice to make in your life. And this can be the universe letting you know that the energies are going to be available for you to be able to make this choice and this decision. And it's a choice and a decision that could have been made in the past, previously, prior to now, but for whatever reason, we've held off on making it. But stepping into a time where this decision, this choice can be made. And it's coming in attached to the Five of Swords, which is that energy of feeling like somebody had your back to only to learn that they didn't, right? So a choice and a decision that's connected to that energy. That's me thinking. I feel like there are a lot of messages in today's tarot reading, different messages for each and every one of us. Okay. All right, coming in next and showing up attached to the Justice card, showing up at the center of today's tarot love reading, we have the Ten of Swords. A graphic card, right? We see a figure here laying face down in the snow, and she has 10 swords impaled in her back. So these swords represent lessons, right? Painful lessons, right? And some of this lessons, this 10 of Swords, could be connected to this 5 of Swords, right? This experience of feeling like somebody had your back to only to learn that they didn't. That could have very well been one or several of these swords. But this is the universe letting you know that your lessons have been learned, right? Now that the lessons have been learned, there's no sense in rehashing and relearning again. So it's time to let them pass. So usually this is followed up by a beginning of some sort. I mean, I have to say this. I feel like some of you are saying, thank God it's over with. I do, especially with the Justice card coming in above this, right? This is really going to allow you to bring the fairness and the balance back into your life, to really allow these swords to pass. So if this resonates with you, and if you're still hanging on to any of those limiting energies, just recognize that and be aware of that and work on allowing them to pass, right? It's now time to move on. Okay, so coming in attached to the Eight of Cups, we have the Ten of Cups. Interesting. So the Ten of Cups is a good energy, as it represents the energy of two people coming together in union, right? So Ten of Cups lets me know, you know, maybe these two people are seasoned, a little more experienced, right? They're not young kids. She's holding a child, right? He's holding them both, so yeah. Represent the energy of, you know, possibly getting together a little bit later in life, maybe even merging families. Okay. All right, coming in next and coming in attached to the Chariot card, we have the Seven of Cups. So the Seven of Cups is a good energy, representing the energy of having a lot of choices. Just like the figure here in the card, she has all of these cups that she's being offered in different directions, but she's not receiving any of them. It could be because the cup she wants is down here on the ground with this rainbow coming out of it, right? Maybe reminding us, right? If we feel like our energies are scattered, we don't have the clarity we'd like to have as it pertains to some of the choices that come, you know, that follow this Ten of Swords completion. Get grounded, you know, go for a walk barefooted at the park, hug a big tree. Yeah, that it could be a kind of an important energy coming in attached to the Chariot, right? Which is about balance. Sometimes that you know, grounding like that can really help rebalance you. Okay. Alright, so the energy taking us out of today's tarot love reading is the King of Pentacles. King of Pentacles representing Earth sign energy. So Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, King, so we think of male energy, but it doesn't have to be. Represents that energy of security, of stability. So the King of Pentacles is not inexperienced, right? It's a very seasoned and experienced energy. Been through the ups and downs of life, right? Only made him stronger. Now he has this wisdom and this experience to bring with him to kind of create this stability and security. Okay. All right. I like today's tarot reading. I'm really interested to look at it, kind of anxious. I'm going to take a moment now. I actually may go after some further clarification as well on this reading. But I want to look at it first, and I actually kind of may read it start to finish first, and then maybe do the clarification after that. So anyways, I'm going to take a look at this. Hang on for a moment here while I do this, and I'll come right back and share the whole reading with you. Just need to kind of, I need to see where the cards are placed, and I need to feel what the messages are exactly that are meant to be shared today. So hang on just a moment. Okay, I think I have it here. So just overall, what I'm feeling from this tarot reading is, and it's going to be different for each and every one of us, right? So I feel like for some, there's a difficulty that you're going through in overcoming a painful, what could be a breakup, or could be a job loss. Some kind of breakdown in communication, right? Something, a Five of Swords, a painful experience that happened, connected to a series of experiences, Ten of Swords. And you're having a difficult time allowing this Ten of Swords completion to take place. So I feel like what we're going to share with you in today's reading is some valuable insight on how you can best navigate yourself and allow this Ten of Swords ending to pass, which you really want to be able to do, because joy awaits you, right? Greater joy. Anyways, let me start here. So the opening affirmation taking us into today's tarot love reading is joy, right? As I do will, so mote it be, let joy and light radiate from me. Okay, so joy and light radiating from me, coming from within. So a lot of times, if we're hanging on to limiting energies, right, from past painful experiences, they're within us, right? Those limiting energies are staying within us, which can sometimes prevent us from being able to receive those energies of joy and bliss. Okay. So the opening energy taking us into today's tarot love reading is the Knight of Wands. Okay, and I feel like the reason this energy is showing up, because it's representing speed and movement, right? Even some urgency is the energy taking us into this reading, which I feel like is the universe kind of pointing out that, you know, now is the time, right? no better time than today just to get started on allowing this Ten of Swords experiences to pass. Okay, so an energy that would serve you very well, right, in allowing these limiting energies to pass is to see if you can try to embrace the energy of the Fool, right? It's showing that it's available here for you, which is great, right? So embrace this energy of the Fool, letting go of our fears, our worries, our concerns, whatever has happened in the past, right? I feel like it's been pretty painful for some of you. Moving into this journey, right, not carrying that baggage, those limiting energies. What's attached to this is the Page of Wands, right, which is representing news, a message coming in by way of a fire sign, if so, a younger energy. There's something about this message, this news, that is connected to overcoming this Ten of Swords energy. So it's going to be different for all of us. Okay, so yeah, the reading seems really clear to me, right, in terms of understanding it. So coming in next, we have the Five of Swords, right, representing that limiting energy of being stabbed in the back. What's attached to it is the Hanged Man, right? So this is a heavy energy, right? Limiting energy for somebody or somebody's out there. Still hanging on to this energy, right? That painful past, but stepping into a time now where the universe is letting you know, hey, you're open to let this energy go now, right? Allow this Ten of Swords, this completion to take place. And you really do want this completion to happen, right? Because it's weighing you down. When you allow this Ten of Swords completion to take place, right? The lessons are learned. I can now stop carrying those memories, those feelings, those limiting energies from what's happened in the past. It brings justice into your life, right? Fairness and balance, right? It's a balancing of your energy. It's important. Okay, and coming in next, we have the Eight of Cups. Eight of Cups representing that energy of walking away from something, right? A person, a place, or a thing, or something within us, right? So I feel like the message here is pretty clear in terms of this is just the universe really encouraging us once again. If we're stuck in these Five of Swords and Ten of Swords energy, right? To move past, right? To walk away from them, allow the completion to take place, it'll be necessary. Moving forwards into Ten of Cups kind of relationships. Whether this is the same relationship, the same individual, which may be the case for some, or this represents a brand new relationship moving forward. Right? And it may be a romantic relationship, but it doesn't have to be. It can be a business relationship, you know, a working kind of relationship. It could be a friendship. Okay, so I feel like this Chariot, I feel like the Chariot's been running for a while, right? He's been en route for a while. Universe letting you know, right? This movement, this change that you're desiring, it's coming in, right? And it'll continue to come with balance, right? It's just a matter of allowing these completions to take place. And what happens when the completion takes place is it steps you into a time where you have all kinds of choices and opportunities in front of you. You're able to disconnect yourself from these limiting energies, and doing so, it's like it opens up doors for you. It changes and shifts the energy within you, and maybe it's that energy shift within you that causes the manifestation of all these choices, right? Doors opening up for you. Taking us to the energy steering us out of today's tarot love reading, which is the King of Pentacles, right? Representing wisdom and experience, right? That's what the King of Pentacles is all about, right? And he takes these experiences, painful experiences, allows him to complete, and he pulls out the wisdom and the truth, right? His true takeaway from those experiences. And that's what he keeps with him, right? And now he's learned that, so he doesn't need to go through it and learn it again. And I feel like that's kind of what's being represented here with the King of Pentacles showing up at the end of today's tarot love reading. Okay. All right, so I'm just wondering if we need to get any further clarification. Give me just a moment and let me just take a look at it from that perspective and see real quick. Okay, so I'm going to pull out my second deck here of Universal Tarot. The first area I want to get a little further clarification on is this Five of Swords, right? The energy of being stabbed in the back. Okay, tell us more about the Five of Swords. Further clarification. Five of Swords. Okay. All right, so getting further clarification on the Knight of Swords, not surprised to see that we have the Ten of Wands, right? So the Ten of Wands represents the energy of what may feel like it's been a long journey, right? Finally coming to an ending. It's also, I'm feeling this, so I need to point it out, right? So this Five of Swords is the energy of feeling like, being stabbed in the back, right? Just notice how inefficient he is, right, in carrying these wands, right? It's like they're going to fall out of his hands at any moment. So, and I feel like that's what that's representing is by hanging on to this Five of Swords energy. You're really holding yourself. You're holding yourself back, right? You're not able to operate as efficiently as you normally could. But this Ten Wands is saying it's time for it to come to an ending, right? Allow this journey to come to a close. And attached to it is the Knight of Swords, right? So the Knight that shows up always shows up. He brings truth, right? And he's coming in quickly. So I feel like the message is coming through with some urgency. Okay. All right, now I want to ask just a little bit about the Ten of Swords, right? Get a little further clarification on that. So tell us more about the Ten of Swords. Okay, so getting further clarification on the Ten of Swords, and I now have the Seven of Pentacles, right? So Seven of Pentacles, it's a good energy. It represents the energy, he's been working hard, right? Creating these pentacles. Now that he's created them, he's taken time to sit back and reflect. And he's looking at what he's manifested, right? So it's coming in connected to this Ten of Swords, right? Representing those limiting energies from painful experiences of the past. I feel like this is the universe letting you know, right, that you're aware of this. Right, you're kind of in that decision mode right now. Why? It's coming in right next to the Hanged Man, right? So definitely a choice and a decision, right? So some of you are right at that stage, right, trying to decide. Hopefully this reading inspires you. Okay. All right. Last thing I want to do is ask about this Ten of Cups. Tell us more about the Ten of Cups. Further clarification on the Ten of Cups, please. Okay. All right, so interesting. So getting further clarification on the Ten of Cups, right? So the Ten of Cups is that energy representing two energies coming together, right? So for many, it's relationship related. It doesn't have to be. We see the Five of Swords again, right? So Five of Swords was here earlier in the tarot reading, right? This energy, you see these two guys, they've been fighting, you know, with their swords, and they're discouraged. They're walking away. Their swords are laid on the ground. This guy may have think he's won, right? But it's a shallow victory. So yeah, definitely connected, I believe, to a relationship. You know, the energy of, for many, of somebody letting you down, probably a breakup of some sort. Whether you're staying in the same relationship, which may be the case for some of you, or whether you're looking to take on a new relationship, it's just very important for you to recognize this Five of Swords limiting energy, right? That's holding you back. You just don't want to take it with you into the same relationship or a new relationship. Anyways, allow these Ten of Swords to pass, right? Allow this beautiful joy, fantastic energy into your life, coming from within. Okay, guys. I hope you enjoyed this Sunday tarot read. I enjoyed sharing it with you. I hope you've all had a beautiful weekend. I have. Thanks. Have a great night.